all kinds of organisms need to be able to protect their genetic material from any kind of threat, be it environmental or simply metabolic processes. Nucleotide excision repair, or NER, is a type of DNA repair that removes DNA lesions that distort the helix and make it look all wonky. It's particularly important in removing DNA damage caused by UV light, because UV light gets absorbed by thymine and cytosine bases, and this added energy causes a photochemical reaction with a neighboring base, causing a covalent bond to form between them. We call these pyrimidine dimers, in this case it's a thymine dimer, and they're dangerous because they can cause a kink in the DNA, which can stall polymerase or cause a misread. We can see just how important nucleotide excision repair is because some severe human diseases like xeroderma pigmentosum and Cockayne syndrome are caused by genetic mutations of proteins in the nucleotide excision repair pathway. The steps of nucleotide excision repair are similar in organisms from unicellular bacteria to complex mammals. To give a quick overview, they all involve recognition of a DNA lesion, the helix is unwound, then incisions are made on both sides of the lesion so that the part of the DNA with the lesion is removed, leaving behind an empty space. This space is patched up using the undamaged complementary strand as a template. Then it's ligated to restore the DNA to its original form. It's quite an amazing process, and in this video we're going to go into some more detail about the pathways and the proteins involved in eukaryotic nucleotide excision repair. The first step in any kind of DNA repair process is the detection of the damaged area. In nucleotide excision repair, there are two subpathways, global genome repair and transcription coupled repair. The difference between them is how they recognize the damage during the first step, but after that, they have the same process for incision, repair, and ligation. So, the first step is damage recognition, and this is where the two subpathways differ. In global genome repair, the entire genome is examined for distortion in the helix. A protein called XPC is the main damage sensor, and it's stabilized by RAD23B and centrin-2. This complex recognizes helix distortion and bending anywhere in the genome. Except sometimes the DNA helix isn't destabilized enough for the XPC complex to recognize it. Lesions that don't specifically destabilize the DNA helix, but by themselves cause a little distortion of the helix, are recognized by the DDB complex consisting of two subunits, DDB1 and DDB2. DDB stands for DNA Damage Binding Protein, but these are also known as XPE binding factors. What DDB does is it kinks the DNA so that XPC can recognize and bind better. In either case, once the XPC complex is bound, it recruits the transcription initiation factor 2H to the repair site. Our other subpathway, transcription coupled repair, is a repair system that's activated when RNA polymerase 2 is stalled by a lesion in the template strand during transcription. So, transcription coupled repair is dedicated to the removal of lesions from the template DNA strands of actively transcribed genes and enables transcription and gene expression to resume. A translocating RNA polymerase can be blocked by bulky adducts like the ones caused by the pyrimidine dimers we talked about and by discontinuities in the template strands like nicks and gaps. Transcription coupled repair has different proteins than global genome repair. When RNA polymerase 2 stalls, this recruits transcription-coupled specific proteins, CS. CSB strongly binds to the polymerase when it's blocked at a lesion and changes the DNA conformation by wrapping the DNA around the protein itself. CSB recruits the CSA complex and other nucleotide excision factors. CSA is required for the recruitment of XAB2 and nucleosome remodeling factor called HMGN1 and transcription initiation factor 2H to the repair site. The subpathways converge again when transcription initiation factor 2 is recruited to the repair site, and it's all the same after that. Our second step in nucleotide excision repair is local unwinding. Transcription initiation factor 2H is a transcription initiation complex that comprises of 10 proteins, two of which are ATPases or helicases called XPB and XPD, which unwind the DNA to create a 20 to 30 nucleotide bubble. Once this pre-incision complex is assembled, RPA and XPA are recruited to keep the DNA strands apart. RPA binds the single-stranded DNA opposite the lesion, protecting it from degradation and helping coordinate repair. Our third step is dual incision. For dual incision, XPA recruits the XPF-ERCC1 endonuclease to incise the damaged DNA 5' to the lesion. Once XPA recruits XPF-ERCC1, XPG incises 3' to the bubble. So we've created two incisions on both ends of the lesion. The lesion is excised in an oligonucleotide fragment, leaving behind a single strand gap. This gap tells the cell, uh-oh, we've got major damage, we need to fix this ASAP, and signals for a DNA damage signaling reaction. Finally, we get to repair synthesis. Repair synthesis is performed by DNA polymerase delta, kappa, or epsilon with the help of accessory proteins RFC, PCNA, and RPA. Together, they form a complex that synthesizes a new strand to replace the damaged strand with the proper nucleotides. Polymerase epsilon is active for nucleotide excision in replicating cells and can do work on its own without PCNA, which is a clamp, and RFC, which is a clamp loader. Polymerase delta and kappa, however, are the main nucleotide excision polymerase in non-replicating cells, where there's a lower concentration of free-floating nucleotides. These need PCNA and RFC. In the end, we need to ligate the DNA to make sure we have a nice, smooth finishing. The remaining nick in the DNA backbone is sealed with ligation by either ligase 1 or ligase 3 alpha XRCC1. Ligase 1 seals the DNA in replicating cells, while ligase 3 alpha and its cofactor XRCC1 carry out the step in non-replicating cells. And alas, we've repaired the DNA strand. Good as new. Thanks for watching.